The year was 1914, 100 years ago. Charlie Chaplin played the Little Tramp, his most famous character. Edgar Burroughs published Tarzan of the Apes. And George Washington Carver began experimenting with peanuts as a new cash crop in the southern United States. The Toronto Blue Shirts hockey team won the Stanley Cup. On a tragic note, World War I began. But on an eternally significant note, a small group of Christians began to meet and worship the Lord in the home of Mr. and Mrs. Rudery on Elder Avenue in the Long Branch community. This group was the seedbed of what they would officially call themselves 1 year later, Long Branch Baptist Church, with 24 charter members. The spring of 1914 not only marked the beginning of their worship services, they also secured property on Lakeshore Boulevard through a loan. This little flock of worshipers was at first a mission of the Church Extension Board of the Baptist Convention of Ontario and Quebec. The property purchased is roughly the same property upon which our present church building stands today. Construction of that first building began on November 1st, and the first worship service in the new building took place on December 20, 1914. 7 years later, in 1921, George Vickery and his wife, Daisy, came into the fellowship of Long Branch Baptist Church as members numbers 102 and 103. Those who have been with us at Long Branch in recent decades will recognize that this couple were the parents of five of our longtime faithful members: Marjorie Evans, the late Kay Wood, the late Gwen King, the late Howard Vickery, and Audrey Osher. Mrs. Vickery shared some of the following memories of Long Branch's history when she was interviewed 30 years ago for Long Branch's 70th anniversary celebrations. She recalled that most people lived near enough to walk to the church in those days. Some did come with horse and buggy, which they parked in the field around the church building. Long Branch was mainly a summer resort in those days, but new housing was being built all around the growing community. The old white frame church building on our present site contained a big potbelly stove that was in the back room. Mrs. Vickery and others had to continually go downstairs to bring up another armful of wood to burn. The Vickery family lived on 27th Street, near the lake, and attended three times each Sunday. In the decades that followed, Mrs. Vickery recalled that the Sunday school enrollment eventually rose to over 500. Jack Scruton was the superintendent. The junior church had about 100 children. To accommodate the growing church over the years, a building project began in 1950 to construct the brick building, mainly for the worship sanctuary. That is now the gymnasium. In 1957, construction on an adjacent building began, which includes the present worship auditorium. And in 1960, two additional floors were added to provide more Sunday school space. The basement was renovated for a worship auditorium, and our most recent building renovations from 2000 to 2002 provided Long Branch with a welcoming front foyer, air conditioning, wheelchair-accessible washrooms, a lift to connect all five levels of the building, and other improvements to the flooring, auditorium, and offices. Various church members graciously provided loans to meet the $618,000 cost of these renovations. The loans were either paid off by the church or forgiven by 2005, allowing the church to be debt-free to the glory of God. Many Long Branch Baptist Church members have given countless hours of physical labor to these renovation projects over the years, for which we are grateful. Not only that, but a number of our men have given weeks of time over the years to build churches in connection with the Baptist builders of our Canada-wide FEB churches. A number of people from LBBC also donated many hours of labor in the early 1990s when Heritage Baptist Bible College and Seminary bought buildings and property in Cambridge, Ontario, and needed cleanup and renovation crews to help them.
My name is Carl Bannister, and I've been in this church for quite a number of years, and I want to make a comment on the renovations that we did here, starting, I think it was in 2000. We did an extensive renovation on this church, and one of the amazing parts of it all was the way people rallied around the whole project. We had a tremendous amount of money was spent. I think it was over $600,000, and the people rallied even after the renovations were finished, rallied to pay off the debt very quickly, and we praised the Lord for that. And we couldn't help but notice the interest that was kept up by all the people. They kept involved in whatever way they could. And we just thank God for the unity that we saw in the people and for the results that came out of it all. And so we have so much to be thankful for the people of this church and for the way they get behind projects and the way they endeavor to serve the Lord in whatever way they can. And so we just praise God for the outcome of the facilities that we have here now, and for the improvement, the elevator, the extended entrance way of the church, and everything has made a big improvement in the church. So we thank God for the leading that He has carried out here amongst the people over the last 100 years, and we thank God that He's still involved with us and has promised to be with us until Jesus Christ returns.
Of course, the history of Long Branch Baptist Church is far more than brick and mortar, holding a long-term investment in missions endeavors beyond the Long Branch neighborhood. For example, in 1947, Long Branch Baptist Church took on a missionary project of $1,000, which included $700 to the Union of Regular Baptist Churches and $100 each to Mr. and Mrs. Russell Hughes, Mr. and Mrs. Ted Knetchel, and Mr. and Mrs. Bernard Jeffrey. By 1953, Long Branch Baptist Church was regularly supporting Miss Mabel Davis, the Knetchels, and the Hughes in their missionary work. A 1963 annual report tells of the following missionaries being regularly supported as part of Long Branch Baptist Church's missionary family. Mabel Davis, Medellin, Colombia. Ted and Dorothy Knetchel, Brazil. Russell and Gladys Hughes, South Africa General Mission. Fred and Dot Simmons, South Africa. Jerry and Jean Morehouse, Chad. Charles and Mary McCordick, appointees to Chad. June Wade, Voice of the Andes in Quito, Ecuador. Eric and Mary Helen Wright, appointees to Pakistan. And Ron and Audrey Matthews, appointees to Colombia.
I'm Jerry Morehouse, and I've served with TEAM down through the years. My wife and I went to French Equatorial Africa first, and then we served in Chad, which is the same country with a different name. First of all, let me congratulate you on your celebration of your centennial at Long Branch Baptist Church. You have reached a significant milestone in your ministry for God in Toronto's West End. It was in 1950s that Jean and I and our family first attended Long Branch. Over the years, I've referred to Philippians chapter 1 on many occasions. I thank God for every remembrance of you. And then in verse 5, Paul says, I thank God for your fellowship in the gospel from the first day until now. And as I say these things, I'm thinking of many whom I knew through the past years, your predecessors in the work, as well as many in the church now. In 2002, rather, my dear Jean went to be with the Lord, and you were there with your comfort and love. In 2011, I married Ines, and once again, you were there to give consideration and love to me and to Ines as well. Be assured, dear friends, of our prayers as you continue your work in the West End of Toronto, and that God's blessing will be upon that ministry. Oh, God bless you and use you for His glory in the days ahead. What a wonderful hope we have in our Lord. One day we'll see Him face to face, and as we do, we'll be with Him forever. My prayer for you is, God bless you and continue to use you.
In 2012, Long Branch Baptist Church celebrated the retirement of Terry and Elaine Renault after 40 years of service with TEAM in Chad, France, and Nepal. Long Branch Baptist Church missionary family now includes George and Janet Barathan, who raise awareness and support for ministry to the Dalits in India, Mario and Rose Bruno in Rome, Italy, McTerr and Suzanne Wall in France, Benji and Indrani Devadasan with SIM in the Greater Toronto Area, Charlie and Cindy McCordick in Chad as well as at Heritage Bible College, Emerson and Miriam Kyung in Eastern Asia, Phil and Jeanette Taylor in England, Jose and Douglas Castillo in Cuba, Man Bahadur and Sundari Tanrakar in Nepal, and David Amune in Nigeria.
Great. First of all, we want to say congratulations for these 100 years of existence and ministry in the Long Branch area. And our connection with Long Branch goes back a quarter of a century. Believe it or not, we came in at the end of the 80s, 1980s, to do an internship, and we never left until you sent us to the field in France, where we have been serving for the last 23 years. And so we are just so thankful for your ministry to us over all of these years. We are thankful that God has used you to have an impact in the heart of France. One of the things I've really appreciated about Long Branch is that it has changed with the community over the years, and I think this is a wonderful value, an indication of the church's growth into the future.
And when I think of Long Branch, I think of this very warm and loving church family that we have. And we know that we can count on you, and we've seen it over and over and over again, how you care for us and for our ministry. When we came with Lionel and Laura, our pastoral couple in France, you adopted them just the way you adopted us, and we're so thankful for this wonderful church, home church that we have here.
We're thankful for faithful pastors over the years. Bernard Jeffrey had the longest pastorate, a total of 20 years from 1934 to 1953. This includes his 5 years as a padre with the Canadian Armed Forces overseas during World War II. During those 5 years, Stanley Wellington oversaw both nearby Beulah Baptist as well as Long Branch Baptist. Other memorable pastors who have served here in recent decades include Sam Elliott in the late 1950s, John Reisinger in the early 1960s, Raymond Reed and Morris Russell in the late 1970s, Eric Wright in the 1980s, David Russell and Don Scotland in the 1990s, and the late Randy Singbiel from 2002 to 2006. In April 2008, Rob Miner began his ministry with us, joined by Pete Noyd as youth pastor in 2010. Long Branch Baptist Church has been instrumental over the years in helping to plant new churches such as Beulah Baptist, Kenmure Baptist, and Bramley Baptist. The church has helped to develop student interns and assistant pastors, such as Glenn Bowles, Tim Roberts, Jim Parker, Ken Davis, Glenn Cordery, Andrew Gordon, Emmanuel Palisak, Dwayne Francois, Chris Warrock, and Terry Siona, as well as Bob Irvin, Doug Monet, and Steve Semple, to name a few.
Hi, my name is Ken Davis. I'm currently the pastor at Thistletown Baptist Church in Rexdale, in Toronto. The official title of my position at Long Branch was assistant to the pastor. I think that word "to the" was put in so that the church wouldn't have to vote on me, but I'm not sure. So I was the pastor's assistant. I came here in 1978 when Morris Russell was the pastor. I had been a member of Pastor Russell's church in St. John's, Newfoundland. Then he came here from St. John's, and I started here when I started in at seminary. In 1978, I was here from the fall of 78 to graduation of 81 as assistant to the pastor, youth pastor, and general do whatever I tell you pastor. Okay? Long Branch has always meant a lot to me because it's the first church I pastored. And my memories of Long Branch, there are several that stand out to me. One is Peter McFarland kept my car on the road. I had a little Toyota that was in the habit of breaking down, and I was a student, had no money, and Peter kept it on the road for me. Tuesday night visitations, my usual Tuesday night visitation partner was Shirley Presley. Shirley taught me how to visit. She taught me how to give a testimony. She taught me how to be firm and yet polite and quiet. And Shirley Presley taught me the meaning of the phrase quiet strength, because she's very quiet, very strong, very unashamed of the gospel. And I can remember two or three specific settings where she just, dealing with difficulty, just gave the gospel to people right from her heart. This church got me through seminary because I was the associate pastor. I don't know if you still do it, but Long Branch paid my tuition, gave me a little stipend for the pastoral work I was doing, but paid my tuition, and that got me through seminary. But Long Branch just taught me what real Christian faith is. I just love this place because it's where I cut my pastoral teeth. In the last year I was here, Pastor Russell left in, I think it was October, in the fall anyway, of 1980. I was in my last year of seminary. I had to choose between giving up some time here or giving up some courses, and I just couldn't bear to give up time here, so I gave up some courses and to put more time in here after Pastor Russell left. So I never did get my master's, but I think I made the right choice. I'm just thrilled that you're even desiring to hear from me. I love this church. It's good to come here and still see some of the people that were here when I was here. Thrilled to see Rowan so heavily involved. He was in my youth group when I was here, and now he's an elder, and that's just thrilling stuff. And congratulations on turning 100. We look forward to being here next spring when some of the celebrations are on. And God bless you. You poured into me, and I'd like to be able to say to you, you didn't waste your time. And I hope that other people have benefited in my pastoral life from my pastoring of them because of what I learned here, and I'm sure that's the case. Thank you very much. Love you guys.
Our church has helped people over the years in the midst of crucial turning points in their lives. Tiggist is one of them.
Hello, I'm Tiggist, and I'm here today to say happy 100th anniversary. I'm just happy to be here, and I just want to say thank you to all of you, Allah, each one of you, and may God bless all of you. I know the Lord touched me and blessed me through this church, and I wish you all the best for the next many, many hundred years, and may God bless you, and I love you.
We rejoice that over the years, God has used not only the pulpit ministry, but the ministry of our members, such as our youth leaders, to see lives come to faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Ian Davis is one example.
So for as long as I've been coming here, Long Branch has been like my home. There are so many people here who've just loved me and invested in me. They're always there to really just ask me how I'm doing and to really show a care and interest. And I really needed that. So they're like my family, and I consider them to be like my family. So this is just an amazing place, and I am so blessed to be a member here and to be able to go here every single Sunday.
Ministries among us in recent years include our clothing outlet ministry every Friday morning, Ben and Linda Chan's ministry with Mandarin-speaking students, and various youth ministries led by our youth pastor Pete Noyd and many wonderful volunteers. We as a church want to thank all of those who have served over the years on our elders and deacons boards. Tom King and Dave Osier, for example, served on the leadership board for many years, but have now retired. Our present elders board includes six men who have all served faithfully now for quite a number of years. Peter McFarlane and Carl Bannister have served the longest, followed by Noel Nicholson, Rohan Archer, Colin Bannister, and John Wright. We are thankful for various volunteers who serve so faithfully among us year after year. Those who lead us in worship. Those who serve in the nursery. Those who teach our children the Word of God. Those who help with our summer camps. Those who help with the youth events. Those who serve in the kitchen. Those who serve in the clothing outlet. Those who help with our audio and visual equipment. Those who keep our building in good shape. Those who serve in friendship ministries. Those who help others in conversational English. Those who open their homes to host encouragement groups. Those who visit the shut-ins and the sick. Those who reach out into the community in creative ways. Those who pray so faithfully. We extend a big thank you to one and all, and to God be the glory for the great things He has done. May we seek to fulfill God's purposes in our generation and in each generation of believers until Jesus comes again to take us home.
The moon and stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross, His blood poured out for us. The weight of every curse upon Him. One final breath He gave, as heaven looked away, the Son of God was laid in darkness.
A lost world with
we need it. A church set on fire.
Set on fire.
Set on fire. To laugh with, to grieve with, to give and receive with, to hope and believe with. Serve with, to love and to learn with, to reach a lost world with, my family in Christ, to reach a lost world with, my family.
God, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not, Thy compassions, they fail not. As Thou hast been, that forever wilt be. Great is Thy faithfulness. Great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. Faithfulness. grace.